Hi, everybody. This is Adam Elenbaas from Nightlight Astrology, and these are your horoscopes for the month of April 2019. So this is the Sun and Rising Sign horoscope for Pisces. All right, let's take a look. So this month, I'm breaking things up in terms of major themes rather than looking at everything in terms of individual transits. Basic reading for the reason for this is that there's such a cluster of transits all around the same dates that it doesn't make sense to go through them in a strictly linear fashion. So to keep it a little simpler, I'm breaking it up into themes, mostly based, by the way, on the lunar cycle this month. So for example, towards the beginning of the month, you'll see that the new moon in the sign of Aries falls in your second house, which is the house of money, finances, or resources, and also expenditures, things that you have that you either that either come into your possession or that go out of your possession. Now, with a new moon cycle there, there is a moment of perhaps newness or a sort of a new seed that's being planted around money, finances, expenses, etc. And it may have something to do with domestic issues, home, family, roots, foundation, parents, land or property. The reason for this is that we see the dispositor of the new moon in Aries, Mars, entering and just moving into the fourth house of money, or excuse me, of home and family at the time of the new moon in the house of money and finances. So now Mars is, of course, a little confrontational. Mars may bring with it a little bit of difficulty or confrontation or conflict, but this isn't an awful Mars right now. So I don't think this is the worst thing in the world. However, I will mention that at the beginning of the month, Mercury is moving into a conjunction with Neptune in your first sign and home house, Pisces. And it's doing so as the dispositor of Mars in the fourth house. What does this mean? One thing that I'm a little bit concerned about is the sense of a personal sense of needing to give or sacrifice something on behalf of home or family that overwhelms you emotionally, or the ability that you may be manipulated, in other words, or you may emotionally feel compelled to sacrifice or give something or spend something for the sake of someone or something in the home or family. And it may not be entirely wise. Because Mercury with Neptune is sometimes a little fuzzy or a little easily manipulated emotionally, the feeling of needing to spend something or do something or give something to a family member or for the sake of home and family could overwhelm you. Like just as easily you could want to spend money on something in your home this month that's really not necessary or something like that. So I think, you know, being a little bit careful about that. The other thing is, in general, anything this month related to money and finances that feels more impulsive and extreme and not well thought out, maybe rooted in the desire for something bigger or better. For example, by the 12th, we'll see Mercury in a square with Jupiter in the 10th house, which could very easily signal a personal desire to expand and get bigger and or be more recognized or something like that, which may filter down, in other words, on some level to thinking you need to spend money on something this month. And I would just be careful about that. The other thing that I would look at this month is kind of the one of the main themes of the month is something about money and finances, also potentially within the context of relationships. The full moon, on the other hand, is in Libra, and the full moon in Libra will land in the eighth house, which is sometimes related to spouse's money or other people's money. That full moon in Libra ruled by Venus. And Venus is also going to be going through a conjunction to Neptune in your first house and home sign of Pisces on the 10th, and then a square with Jupiter on the 15th. So all of that is just to say that the full moon around the 19th is going to bring a kind of karmic balancing point that has to do with relationships and finances or investments or debt, expenditures, the balance of power or responsibility in relationships. And I'm kind of warning Pisceans about this month is anything superficial that doesn't really define who you are or your happiness overtaking you and convincing you that you need something that you don't need, or that you are, especially around money and finances, that you go lunging for something, or that makes you afraid of something. Well, this could happen. So I'm moving into a really defensive posture because of fear of losing something or someone. Be careful about those things. The other thing that I'm looking at is there is the potential this month with two planets, Venus and Mercury, going into conjunction with Neptune and then squares to Jupiter in your 10th house. A continued theme of growth and expansion professionally might be at work in your life right now. It's been Jupiter's planet of growth and expansion has been in your career house since last fall, really helping things to grow. But Venus and Mercury and Neptune in the first house square Jupiter, things look good. Things look like they, you know, you might be continuing to grow or expand or receive some kind of benefits or some more greater attention or success. And yet I wonder if there aren't some deeper questions about identity happening this month. Who am I really? How does success or upward movement professionally or socially define me, or does it really define me? And then also questions about, you know, where do I want to go with my life and who am I versus what kinds of conflicts or challenges at home or in my domestic sphere of life are holding me back or keeping me from that. Those may also, those kinds of questions may also come up this month pretty intensely. Underlying all of these transits, another piece is Saturn, the South Node, and Pluto in your 11th house of friends and allies. The Sun in your second house of money and finances will square them. The full moon in the 8th house will square them. This may also come down to a question of, what am I willing to do right now in order to succeed? And is it a good thing, or is it questionable in some way? The reason for this is that Saturn, Pluto, and the South Node are about karmic lessons that we have to learn around who we consider to be allies, or what we consider success to look like, and what we're willing to do or not do in order to try and get success. And it can get pretty Machiavellian with Saturn, South Node, and Pluto in the 11th. So something I've been looking at for Pisceans for a while now is, what are you willing to do and how much are you willing to compromise of your character, your ethics, your money, whatever, for the sake of something that you think you need or that you think will bring you success, whether it's people you work with or whether it's the people you need to surround yourself with or the people you hope will recognize you or things you need to buy or do to get or have. I think those are big themes for Pisceans right now, and I think they're going to intensify all the way into next January, February, when Saturn and Pluto conjoin in your house of allies and benefactors and wishes for the future and stuff like that. The deeper lessons going on right now about your ambitions. And I think it ties in very deeply this month, very concretely on some level, to money and resources. But you can also see, for example, that around the 20th to 19th to the 23rd, Mercury and Venus will get in a conjunction with Chiron in the second house of money and finances. There's a healing moment or an examination of wounds in relationship to money or finances. That's going to be pronounced. and again, the Libra full moon will be about some kind of karmic balancing moment in the month sometimes it's a little painful in the 8th house, but this is a moment of helping you explore dynamic tensions. Wherever you're feeling most aggressive and ambitious, the full moon will pull you back a little bit and try to keep you level-headed. So that's what I've got this month. That's what I'm focusing on for all of you Pisceans out there. I hope that this was helpful. Let me know how things go. I'd love to hear from you and hear your stories. And we'll be back again in May for your next horoscope. Okay, take care.